You might not have chosen all these answers, which is totally okay. I think all these are great, and here's why. We know successful students make mistakes. More importantly, successful students learn from their mistakes. In this course, even if you don't get a problem right on the first time, you should definitely try again. If you try the problem again, you're likely to get the correct answer. Then you can also go back and write yourself a note to remember what went wrong. The thing I want to emphasize is that mistakes are okay. You might even find some mistakes that we made while making the videos. While we try to bring you the best material, we aren't perfect. In the first unit, you'll even see my own handwriting and drawings improve. I made a ton of mistakes while making these videos, but for me, the most important part was to reflect and learn from those mistakes. To be successful in this course, we also recommend you take notes while watching the videos. These notes can be helpful for you to solve practice problems and also help you review content later. It's a great idea to break up your notes into individual lessons. That way you can remember what you learned from each video segment. Third, research tells us that the most learning occurs while working in groups. Students don't succeed just by working harder or studying longer. They do better by talking about math, by discussing it, by practicing it, and teaching others. Usually from lecture, you only remember 5% of what you hear. From reading, you only remember 10%. Audio and visual, 20%, and demonstrations, 30%. These are considered to be passive ways of learning because they don't rely on much from you to, well, learn. When you participate on the forums or complete practice problems after videos, you're becoming an active learner. These are the best things you can do throughout the course to help yourself learn. And if you've really mastered something, that means you can teach anyone. That's the best. Finally, if you're half listening or losing focus, just stop. Take a break and come back and try again. You want to avoid guessing through the quizzes or trying to rush through the material. One thing we know about learning is that there's an actual physical need for time to process new material. So give each question your full attention and your thoughts. Congratulations on completing your first question. We hope you have a better idea of how to succeed in this course. When you're ready, come join us and visualize algebra.